Non so, esprimermi bene in italiano e per quello parlerò in inglese, se va bene. My name is Jürgen Schmidhuber and I'm a scientific director of the Swiss AI Lab, Istituto Dalle Molle, here in Lugano, actually in Mano. And it's affiliated with both the SUPSI now and the USI, which is led by Boas Eres. And he already outlined some of the future possibilities that we may have in this field. Now, many people here in Lugano don't even know that modern artificial intelligence, to a large extent, is based on stuff that was invented here in Lugano. At the Istituto Dalle Molle, in the past few decades, in particular something which is called an artificial neural network, more precisely, long short-term memory, LSTM. And you have never heard of it, but you have it in your pocket, it's on your smartphones, because all the major companies in the world, the most valuable companies in the world, such as Google, Facebook, Tencent, Alibaba, Amazon, Apple, Microsoft, they're all using it like crazy, billions of times a day. What is it? What is that thing which is coming out of Lugano, which was not invented in America or in China, but here in Lugano? It's a little bit inspired by what you have in your brain. In your brain, you've got 100 billion little processors. They are called neurons. And each of them is connected to maybe 10,000 other neurons. And some of these neurons are input neurons, where video is coming in form of little numbers, and audio is coming in through the microphones, and tactile information is coming in through the tactile sensors. And some of these neurons are output neurons. They control the finger muscles, and they control the speech muscles. And in the beginning, all these connections have a strength which is random. Each strength says, how much does this neuron over there influence that neuron over there at the next time step? And in the beginning, the network is stupid. It knows nothing. But then, through learning from lots of training examples, it learns to do all kinds of interesting things, such as driving a car or recognizing speech. And in fact, today, if you are using Google, if you say, okay, Google, what is the shortest way to the station, then it understands your speech. And in 2015, Google speech recognition became much better than what it was before, because they are using now this invention from here, from Lugano, from the Istituto Dalle Molle, and from Munich, my other lab in Munich. And so this is now on billions of smartphones, and it's used billions of times a day. And the same LSTM also has learned to translate from one language to another. Google Translate in 2016 has become much better than before, because since then they are using this LSTM, which is learning from lots of examples to understand language and how to translate from one language into another. And 1 year later, 2017, Facebook did the same thing. Is anybody here on Facebook? Anybody on Facebook? Mm-hmm. Is anybody not on Facebook? Mm. Yeah. I see we have a third group in this room who didn't understand the question. But if you are on Facebook, then you know there's a little button, and you click there, and then you get a translation of the message from your Spanish friend, for example. And again, that's an LSTM, which was not invented in Silicon Valley or in China or somewhere. No, it was invented here in the pre-Alpine country, in Munich and in at ETSIA, here in Lugano. And Facebook alone is using it 4 billion times a day, 30 billion times a week. To compare, the most successful video on YouTube has about 6 billion clicks, and it needed 2 years to get that. But LSTM is getting 30 billion clicks every single week. So an algorithm here from Lugano is already influencing the modern world in a very strong way, and a large part of the computational power of the world is really used for this method here. So it's already true that artificial intelligence from Lugano has had a major impact. Similarly, in healthcare. In healthcare, in 2012 already, my team here was able to win a competition where the goal was to do cancer recognition. And our network was totally stupid in the beginning, but then it learned through lots of training examples to imitate human doctors, and it was able to beat the entire competition. And today all the major companies, like IBM, here we have IBM, is doing that. Google is doing that. Siemens is doing that. They have now major departments just for improving healthcare and medical diagnosis through these learning artificial neural networks. And what do we want to do now? Based on this history of successes here from Lugano in artificial intelligence, we want to do the next step. And what we see at the moment is just the tip of the iceberg. Every single aspect of civilization, of our culture, is going to be transformed by artificial intelligence. And Lugano has an opportunity to become a leader in this next wave. And building on the previous successes, it may be possible to create out of this city here a place where AI, artificial intelligence, is going to help in many, many different ways to make the lives of humans longer and healthier and easier. It's going to be the biggest thing of the current millennium, and Lugano has a chance to be number one in that field. And so that's why I'm trying to convince the politicians, and especially Marco Baradori and his colleagues, to move forward in this direction. And it's I see very promising signs here in the form of the Lugano Living Lab. I see the efforts of Boas Eres, of SUPSI, and of UZI going forward in that direction. And it may indeed be a possibility to transform the image of Lugano weg von der Sonnenstube hin to this AI city, which might play a leading role not only in traffic management, which is one of the current projects that we are looking at, where we are trying to use AI to predict how people are going to react to changes of the wirings of traffic signs and of traffic lights and whatever, and try to improve the throughput and reduce the pollution in the city. But this is just one of many, many ways of improving the lives of the people living here, and to the extent that this is going to work, it will be tremendously exportable, such that the city might be a leading light, not only within Switzerland, but within all of Europe and the rest of the world, because that's going to be the next big thing. So again, Lugano has a great chance to be a leading light in this process of using artificial intelligence to make the lives of people longer and easier and healthier.